Hello, this video will cover how to complete the installment loan and save some time. What you'll first need to do is download the file. So click on the loan file link in Canvas and make sure you read the directions, of course. And once you do that, you will download the Excel file. Once you open up the Excel file, there will be actually three tabs. The first one will be the directions. Make sure you read these directions. The second tab, which will be in the lower, let me see if I can pull it up some so you guys can see it. So the three tabs down here, you have directions, assignment, and schedule. Assignment will have the requirements. Make sure you put in your name. I'm typing in my name, so you type in your name in the name cell, and then read the very first item. Assume you borrowed $25,000 to buy a new car at 2.75% interest to be paid back in monthly installments over the next 5 years. And then you have four different questions that you're going to have to answer. And using the spreadsheet schedule, so click on the schedule, you're going to use this table's amortization schedule to figure out the answer to those questions. So the loan amount is $25,000. And the interest rate is 2.75%. And the number of periods, since it's monthly, it is 12. Number of years of the life of the loan is 5. And what the spreadsheet will do is automatically figure out the factor. As an alternative, if you use table B3, which is in the back of your textbook, you will find that you will also get the same factor available if you look at 60 rows at 2.75% interest, but I don't believe the table has that interest rate. But you can also get the same information for certain percentages using table B3. And then with this, what you'll do next is that you will take the equal payments. This will be your monthly payments, $446.45 with these given factors. And this is basically done just by dividing this factor into the loan amount. So that will allow you to answer your first questions. How much would your monthly payment be? And that will be, $446.45. So 446.45, that will be the answer to the first question, letter A. How much interest expense will be included in your first payment? Now to determine that, if you scroll down just a little bit, you will see that you have a table. And you are going to fill out this schedule. So the first period will be the first, so put in number one. Your payment will be this 446. So when you reference this 446.45, you're gonna either do a plus or equal sign so you can reference it. But what you're gonna have to do is press the F as in Frank, 4 key at the very top of your keyboard. And that will allow you to see these dollar signs in front of the letter C and the letter 10, which will basically mean that it will take the absolute value regardless of where you copy this formula, and it will always reference C10. So you want to make sure those dollar signs are in front of both the C and the 10. So if you keep pushing the F4, you'll see that the dollar signs change, but you want to see two dollar signs, one in front of the letter and one in front of the number. Go ahead and do enter, and that will put the number 446.45 in there. Now to calculate your interest expense, you're going to use the P times R times T formula, which is the principal. And now this principal is going to be the unpaid balance, since this is an installment note, meaning we're paying down a portion of the principal and a portion goes to interest expense as the loan progresses over time. So what we're going to do is we're going to do the unpaid balance. So what I'm going to do is I'm not going to reference the original loan amount. I'm going to reference the current principal. Now for the very first payment, your principal will equal the loan amount. So we're going to go ahead and go to the E15, and we're going to reference that, and we're going to multiply that by the rate. Now the rate is always going to be 2.75%. That's a fixed rate. So kind of like when you do your student loans or you buy a car or a house and it's a fixed rate, you want to make sure that you use the same rate. So I'm going to go to the 2.75%, which is in C5, and I'm going to press the F4 key because I always want it to reference The 2.75%, it doesn't change. Now the principal balance will change as I pay it down. And then I'm going to multiply it by the T. Now the T is the time, and the time period we're talking about for the first payment, it is actually 1 month, which is 1/12. So what I'm going to do is do 1 divided by, and now instead of putting in 12 because I want to use this spreadsheet, I'm going to go ahead and reference where the 12 is, since that's the number of periods per year, that's in C6. And what I'm going to do is press the F4 key again, because I always wanted to go to this field regardless of where I copy the formula. Then I'm going to go ahead and do enter, and you'll see here that the interest expense in the first payment is $57.29. Now, because the interest expense portion is $57.29, what I'm going to do is set up a formula for the reduction in principal portion of the payment. So I'm going to reference my current periods or respective periods payment, which is the 446.45, and I'm going to subtract the current period's interest expense. So I'm going to take the difference between the two. So of this payment, the $446.45, $389.15 is going towards pay down of the principal. So my new principal balance at the end of the first payment will be the previous balance minus the reduction in principal. So now my number is a little bit below the $25,000. So this is my new balance. If I want to pay it off early, this is what I would pay off to the bank or whoever it is that I borrowed it from. So what I'll do is I'll try this again. I'll go to the second period. I'm going to put down number 2. And my payment is still going to be the same. So I'm just going to go ahead and reference that right above it. And then I'm going to have my interest expense. It's going to be the exact same formula. So I don't want to sit there and copy this. So I'm going to, or retype it in. I'm going to just copy it. So I'm going to do copy. So right click on that. Where is it? Copy. And then I'm going to paste, right click again, and I'm going to paste, just the regular paste. And you'll notice that the interest expense is a little bit smaller, which makes sense because my principal balance is smaller. Now my reduction in principal, it's going to be the same exact entry. So when I copy that down, I'm going to get a higher number for my reduction in principal. And then when I look at my new principal balance, again, I'm going to subtract the 390 from the 24. I'm just copying down the formula, and you see that it's getting smaller. Now this is for 5 years, which is 12 months per year. We're talking about what, 60 months. Now I don't want to do this 60 times. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the features in Excel, because I've used that F4 key, I've set up the formulas, I have exactly how I want, and I'm going to just highlight the period through the principal. And if I did it correctly, I'm just going to copy this down for 60 periods. And I don't know if you can see it or not, but in the bottom right hand corner, that plus, that red cross plus, turns into a little black plus. I'm going to hold down, and I don't know if you can see it, but you see it says 6, 7. So as I go down, I want to go down to 60. So I'm going to go a little faster, and I'm going looking for 60. So once I see 60, and I'm going to let go, and what it does is, I've completed my entire table that shows all my interest payments, same payment, and then you'll see that the very last payment has $1.02 for interest expense, and the rest or majority of it is pretty much reduction in principal. And what do you notice about my balance? My principal balance is down to 0. So that's pretty much how you use a spreadsheet. You're using the features in Excel to make it quicker, faster for you, and just make sure you answer the questions correctly. And if you wanted to know the total interest, there's a couple ways you can do that. You can either add up using equal SUN sum and just add up all of the amounts in this column, and you'll get a total. That'll be your total interest. Alternatively, now remember this is for 60 periods. So you can expand this if you had a loan that was a little bit longer. But another way you could do that is you could take your actual payment, multiply it by 60, and then subtract the principal balance, and you can back into the interest that way. So I hope this helps you, and remember, today is a great day to learn accounting.